Hello, hi, welcome to my channel Abbas Computer Learning. My name is Tarika Dedipya and today's topic is CSS background color lesson number 6. Sorry friends for the late upload and late explanations because I have some small situation which was very critical. My small son is not feeling well, so in some cases I'm delay for these videos. So now onwards I'll be regular to my channel and I'm regular to my lessons. Regularly I'll upload my lessons. So now for now I'm going to tell about the CSS background. So the CSS background properties are used to define the background effects for elements, and CSS properties are like CSS background color, background image, background repeat, background attachment and background position. So we are learning about this, elaborating with these colors, image, repeat, attachment and position. So first we are going to see about the CSS background color. The background color property specifies the background color of an element. Here I have given you a small example. This will be displayed light blue background, and with CSS a color is most often specified by a valid color name like red and a hexa value. It is also red color, but it is hashtag FF0000 and an RGB value like RGB bracket 255, 0, 0. It is probably it is a red color only. And I have explained CSS color values for a complete list of the whatever I can tell about the color value. I have done everything. So if you miss it, I have already completed about these colors. And here I have given you a example that angle bracket h1 paragraph and divide element will have different background colors. So you can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. It is very easy. You can easily try by yourself. And here now I'm going to tell about this CSS background image. So the background image property specifies an image to use as the background of an element. By default, the image is repeated, so it covers the entire element. The given you are two examples. Okay, I have given you a two example for this background image. And when using a background image, use an image that does not disturb the text. So this is the image you can use, and the text will be you can see the text clearly. If you use the second image, you can't see the text clearly. So that is the two examples I have given for you. I'll explain in my notepad. And the first, this is the example for the background image for a page can be set. And this is the second example, shows a bad combination of the text and the background image. The text is hardly readable. So note that when using a background image, use an image that does not disturb the text. So next we are going to see about the CSS background repeat. By default, the background image property repeats an image both horizontal and vertical. Some images should be repeated only horizontal or vertical, so they will look strange. Here is an example. You can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. The example above is horizontally repeated. If we don't want to messy image that you can use, then you can use like background dash repeat dot dot repeat dash x. The background will look better. Repeat x is for horizontal, repeat y is for vertical. So if you want to repeat vertical, you can use repeat dash y. If you want to repeat the image horizontal, you can use the x. This is the example for the horizontal repeatedly. Tip is it to repeat an image vertically, set the background dash repeat dot dot repeat dash y. Y is the vertical. Repeating background repeat vertically. So CSS background repeat dot dot non dash repeat. It will be not repeated like this. If I have a image like tree, then you can use the no repeat. Showing the background image only once in is also specified by the background dash repeat property only, the value will be no repeat. No dash repeat. This example shows the background image only once. You can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. In this example, the background image is only showing once, but it is disturbing the reader. So for this cases, in the above image, the background image is placed in the same place as the text. If we want to change the position of the image so that it does not disturb the text too much, so in such cases we use the CSS. This is only image for using the once, and for the no repeating we use the property like CSS background position. So it will be repeat like this, CSS background repeat non repeat. So the background image is only showing once, but it is disturbing the reader. So in such cases we use the CSS background position property. So the CSS background position property is used to specify the position of the background image. Here is the example. So this example position, the background image is the top right corner. So it will be seen like this. Now the background image is only shown once, and the position away from the text. In this example we have all added a margin on the right side, so the background image will never disturb the text. So the CSS background attachment, the background attachment property specifies whether the background image should scroll or not. That means we scroll our our web page now. So that one. So will not scroll with the rest of the page. Here is the example for the background attachment. This specifies that the background image should be fixed. That means the image will be fixed and the text will be scrolled. We write the values like fixed. Here we have written the background dash attachment dot dot fixed. So the image will be fixed and the letters, the text will be scrolled. In the second example, for the background background image should scroll with the rest of this page. So we have written background dash attachment scroll. Then the writing will be scroll. The image also will be in the same place, and the image will be not seen after we scroll the image. So next one is CSS background shortened property. The shortened the code is it is also possible to specify all the background properties in one single property. This is called a shortened property. The shortened property for background is background. We can write everything in one line with making a space between the each property, each value, sorry. Here is the example for the shortened property. By using the shortened property to set all the background properties in one declaration, you can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. I'll be explained step by step. So let's see all the CSS background colors property also. When using the shortened property, the order of the property value is background color and background image. We use these property in a one shortened property. It does not matter if one of the property value is missing, as long as the other ones are in the order. So we can write one in one declaration these color, image, repeat, attachment and position we can write in a one declaration. So let's see all the CSS background properties. Like background is set all the background properties in one declaration. Background attachment, it is sets whether a background image is fixed or scrolled with the rest of the page. Background clip, we have missed this background clip. I'll explain in my next slide. So specifies the painting area of the background. Background color sets the background color of an element. background image is set the background image for an element. Background origin, we have also didn't see about this origin also, so I'll explain in next slide. It will become in the third slide, next slide. So it specifies whether the background images are positioned, and the background position is set to starting the position of the background image, where should it be whatever. And background repeat sets how a background image will be repeated. And background size, we can set our background size also. It specifies the size of the background images. So friends, we have completed our background attachment. We didn't see about the background clip, background origin and background size. So now first we are going to see about the background clip. So it is a background clip. The background clip property defines how far the background color or image should extend with an element. Here is the example for the background clip. It specifies how far the background should extend within an element. We have three types of border box, like padding, content box. You can try by yourself or else wait for my notepad explanation. And here we have written the ID attribute, that means hashtag. We are using the hashtag example 1, hashtags example 2, and we have written this in the divide element. So next we are going to see about the background origin. The background origin property specifies the origin position, the background position area of the background image. Note that this property has no effect if background attachment is fixed. So we can't do anything with background attachment. If it is an background attachment, we can't do any other difference in between the origin and attachment. It is these two are same. Here is the example for the background origin. Let the background image start from the upper left corner of the content. So next, this is the padding box. So you can use that padding box. And next we are going to see about the background size. If you are not getting now, you will get clearly in my notepad explanations. So don't miss my notepad explanations. Now background size. The background size property specifies the size of the background images. There are four different syntax you can use with this property. The keyword syntax like auto, cover and content. The one value syntax sets the width of the image, height becomes auto. The two value syntax, first value width of the image, second value is height. And the multiple background syntax is separate with the comma. This is the example for the background size. It specifies the size of the background image with the auto and its pixels also. So we have completed our topic for our tomorrow's notepad. I'm going to tell every step by step in my notepad explanation, like background color, background image, background repeat, background no repeat, background position, background attachment, background shortened property. And we have seen all the CSS background properties also, and clip, background origin and background size. We are going to see tomorrow in our notepad explanation also. So friends, don't miss it. And so don't miss it. Please do subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you for your support. Signing off, Tarika Dedepia. And after my name, I'll give your YouTube icon. Click on that. So click the subscribe button for the my more notification. Also click the bell icon for my more notification, my new videos to you, my dear friends. And take care. Bye. Keep learning. Happy learning. Bye.